Hello, and welcome to our chapter on artificial intelligence. So we're going to take a look at the power of using the tool ChatGPT to accelerate the creative process and do it responsibly. Now that we're talking about AI, I think it's important to keep a few things in mind. AI and ChatGPT is not perfect. The information that comes out can be biased and inaccurate. So we've got to be aware of that. You as a human who does your job is the best source of understanding what is inaccurate or not. Sometimes the outputs can be kind of generic and flat and machine-like, and the quality is not always there. And as we'll see, AI really requires the human touch. It's not human. It does not know what we know or feel what we feel. I like to say that AI is the spark and we are the flame. And that's really what we're going to talk about today, is that creative spark. Let's say that I or we are instructional designers and we work in a company and we need to make a video that is for onboarding new employees. It should be an engaging explanation of the company's 401k policy. So this is where we're going to paste our prompts in order to generate responses from the chatbot. So I'm going to go ahead and just paste in the prompt that we worked on earlier, and I'm going to click the send button here, and then we'll see words start to come up on the screen. That is the AI very quickly writing answers to what we've asked for. So here it's doing an outline for the video that we requested, and it's dividing it into sections. So this is the first chance we get to see of what the AI thinks about 401ks and what should be taught. Now I can say, write a video script that has 300 words and is in a casual but professional style. So I will go ahead and hit enter here, and we will see it very quickly write this script for us, which includes voiceover, background music, some screenplay about transitions between scenes. It's really kind of incredible that it can so easily convert that outline into a script that guides you through the process. So what if we say include an analogy? I'm just going to scroll down here and hit send. And it does this quite well. So we'll see what kind of analogy it makes up here. Let's see. It's once we get to it, it's a road trip. So the plan is like a road trip to your financial future. Now I say, I like this information, but I want it in the language of a surfer. Right? This could be anything. It could be the Queen of England or whatever it is. I'm going to say surfer, and we'll see how that that turns out here. Cowabunga dudes and dudettes, shedding the wave to financial freedom, right? So we're seeing the same information in the video, but in the style of a surfer. So just like we're using this translation into being a surfer, we can do even other languages. So I can say, you know, now create the script in Spanish. And I believe there's multiple languages that ChatGPT is capable of. I know that Spanish, Chinese, French and German, maybe some others might be a part of that. You know, I need visuals. I need to think about how we're going to transition this into a storyboard. So I'm going to tell it, like, let's go back to English, and I'm saying, this video will be animated with words and visuals, no narration, suggest ideas. Some of the phrases here might work, and some of a list of simple visuals that can be inspiring. Sometimes that is the hardest part, is to think, how do I symbolize this in the video? So again, this is the spark. This is the spark that you can take and make a flame or make a fire that will actually solve the problem you're trying to solve. Let's go back to the original script. And I'd like three new scripts, but for different audiences. A 5-year-old, a 15-year-old, and a 50-year-old. And so ChatGPT knows those ages. It knows what that means, or it has the math behind it to be able to make those connections. So let's hit enter here, and we'll see it start off with a 5-year-old. So it talks about piggy banks, and it's like a special account that helps you save money. It's all in the language that's appropriate for a 5-year-old. It's actually quite good at knowing the context of what a 50-year-old would want to know about a 401k versus a 5-year-old or a 15-year-old. Let's say that our video will explain 401ks from one person's perspective. So we'll use this prompt here, which is about a person named Tom. So using the original script, create a short story told from a first-person perspective. The person is named Tom, 45-year-old programmer, not good with money, trying to decide if he should contribute to the 401k. And so again, we'll hit send here, and we'll see ChatGPT take this prompt and run with it, where it starts off, "Hi, I'm Tom, a computer programmer. I'm gonna say create a persona for Tom." So now ChatGPT knows what that is. It knows this person is Tom and can then think about what is Tom like, what are his feelings about things, what's his background. And so we need to really think about, well, if Tom is like this in this company, then maybe we can think a little bit more about the total audience for the video and say, you know, tell us about the coworkers and like, what are their questions about 401ks? So it dutifully goes through this process. So this is great contextual information for your video that can help you think through what are the questions that I'm gonna need to answer for a broad range of employees. Let's just say that we have all the sort of foundation for our video. We know we're gonna be able to make it, but we're also concerned about, you know, how do we publish it? How do we get it out to people? So I'm going to paste in here, provide ideas for making the most out of this video, including how to share it. So I will put that in the box here, and then it will go through a list of ideas that it has learned from reading the internet, literally every word on the internet that it can, to be able to find, you know, the best ways to do this. But I really need this to be catchy. I want people to really get excited about watching this video, but I can't think of any good titles. So we can do that just the same. So I will just paste in here this prompt, list 10 catchy and fun titles for this video, which ChatGPT does quite well. We can do, you know, 10 more, but funny. Yep, you can see here. Some of these are kind of don't be a 401k potato. Not sure what that means, but that's what's possible. And so that's what I have for right now. But I really just wanted to show you that creating explainer videos is something that takes creativity. It takes some inspiration, and sometimes that doesn't come easy. The analogies and examples and the style of it all. ChatGPT can get you over that hump and get that content down so that you can start focusing on really fitting that message to your audience and making sure that your explanation is not just coming from AI. That's the starting point. You as a human have a role to play in converting the information we've seen here into the language of the people that you work with who are going to see it as something useful and for them. I hope this has been helpful, and I'll see you in the next chapter.